This morning in the Rhode Show Kitchen, Go Providence has brought us Cobb Restaurant. We have Josh, we have Allison, and I'll tell you what, we got a great fall dish to warm you up during this chilly morning. Good morning, guys.
Good morning, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, thank you.
Tell us about what we're making today.
Today we're making sweet potato ravioli.
That's sauteed with spinach and apples in a pumpkin cognac cream sauce.
Nice, like the teamwork there. You're describing the recipe. All right, yeah, exactly. What are the ingredients that we need? A lot of dishes going on here.
We have cinnamon, allspice, nutmeg, cognac, of course, pepper, salt, fresh garlic, shallots, and this is the pumpkin cognac cream sauce. Spinach, apples, and this is actually fried pumpkin skins.
Fried pumpkin skins, which you're going to actually show us how to do that
a
little
later
in the show.
Yes, you have to get your hands dirty.
We've cooked pumpkin before, baked it, however, whatever you want to do, carved it half the time. We've never actually eaten the skin, but this is good. It's edible.
Yes, it's delicious.
I snuck a piece earlier, and it's even kind of resembles like a sweet potato feel, but better, in my opinion.
Yeah, it has a little almond flavor, too.
Okay, we like that, and this is a great recipe. I'm sure that perfect for the fall.
Absolutely. Actually, most people who eat it say that it tastes like a spoonful of fall specifically, so it's pretty good.
We like that. All right, fall is on the menu in the Roadshow Kitchen. We're going to talk about how you can make these pumpkin skins for yourself coming up a little later in the show, guys.
This morning, Go Providence has brought us Cobb Restaurant. Josh is here, Allison's here. And we are going to take care of the pumpkin, right?
You are, yes.
You know what? It smells great in here. And I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's some sort of the spices. It smells like fall in here.
Yes, that's what's going on in this pot.
Yeah, it smells great.
This is the pumpkin cognac cream sauce.
Oh, man.
Not done yet, but allspice, cinnamon, nutmeg.
Yeah.
It's
got to be that nutmeg flavor that you really smell. But this is the pumpkin here. What do you want to do with this?
So I'm going to have you peel it.
Okay.
So, there you go. And peel a couple of strips off.
All right, so which way are we going? We're going down?
You want to go
around?
Twice,
okay,
yeah.
All right. It's a great peeler.
Thanks.
I'll take that off. And how far down do we need to take this?
You're doing a perfect job right
down
there.
Like this.
Yep.
Okay. All right. And about what's. And is this one of the sugar pumpkins or?
No, it's just a regular pumpkin.
Just regular pumpkin. Okay.
And that's perfect.
Okay.
And if you want to get the peels and put them in the bowl over there.
All right, take this. Put this in here. Good.
So we're going to add a little olive oil.
Okay, which is right here. About how much olive oil are we adding to this?
About a tablespoon.
Tablespoon, okay.
Perfect.
Okay.
A little salt.
Mm-hmm.
Pinch. Pinch of pepper.
Okay.
Cinnamon.
All right.
About half a teaspoon.
This in here. Sprinkle that in. Good.
Perfect. And brown sugar.
Okay.
If you ever want to come and work at Cobb, you're doing a great job. I can always use the extra hand.
That's fine with me. All right, so about this much
perfect.
In
perfect. Yep.
All right, good.
You just want to mix that all together, please.
Okay. So put this in. This all together. And
beautiful. And you can put it on the sheet pan right here
okay.
for me.
All right, and then just lay it right out on this.
Yep.
I'm going to move this pump to the side. Okay. Just lay these flat, or do you just... Pull the whole thing out.
Yep.
Okay. Pull that out. Put that together. Good. Looks good and it smells great.
And then you throw it in the oven for about 10 minutes at 400.
Okay. And just really keep an eye on it
so make sure it comes out nice and crisp.
All right. Perfect. Okay. So we've got that in the oven. This smells great. Can't wait to start cooking and start eating. Put it together in our next segment. Back to you. We're back in the Roadshow Kitchen this morning. Josh and Allison are here from Cobb Restaurant. It smells really good. Been cooking away. What do we got to do now?
Now we're ready to do our final
thing. Okay.
Yeah. So the cream sauce we made earlier, we haven't blended it here, but that's...
Tell everybody what's in that again.
So that is pumpkin, diced pumpkin, cream. We have the nutmeg, allspice, cinnamon, some brown sugar, and most importantly, cognac.
Okay, good.
So you blend that and it'll look like this.
So this is what it's gonna look like, the finish?
Yeah, the base for the sauce for the ravioli.
Okay.
So you get a nice pan on our butter. Everybody tells you butter's the best way to start.
Butter makes everything better.
It does. Mm-hmm. It's always good for flavor. So you're gonna put that on there, melt this butter down.
Mm-hmm.
And then we will put on the...
And next, we do shallots.
Okay. Those in there.
And garlic. So you want to sweat this, but not get any color on it.
Okay. So how long will this go for?
Start to finish, this is really only going to take about maybe 4 minutes.
Okay.
Well, the shallots is only going to take like 30 seconds.
Right.
And then our apples.
And what type of apples are we using?
This is just a red delicious apple. Mm-hmm. I mean, you could use anything. I think the red is kind of nicer with the pumpkin, though. It doesn't interfere like green would. Yellow
right.
is nice, though.
Yeah.
It's one of those.
It looks good.
Day. Yeah. And yes, the red color is.
Okay, you slice them pretty thin, too.
Mm-hmm.
So put these on here.
So now comes the fun part.
Okay.
We're going to deglaze the pan with cognac.
All right.
Of course, if you're doing this at home,
watch your eyebrows.
Turn the pan on.
Step back.
Cognac really.
This really does it?
Yeah.
Oh, you're right, it does.
Told you.
There it goes. That was good. That's a good. Sometimes we'll have chefs in here that say, you know, it's going to flame up, and you don't
oh,
see
yeah?
it.
Oh, yeah?
That you see it.
Yeah. So that'll just make everything delicious.
Make everything good.
You just watch it go for a minute here, and it's,
right.
it's the good stuff.
Okay, so this will set, and then what do we need to do?
Next, we're going to add the pumpkin cream mm-hmm. sauce.
That in. And that's the base of everything that we made before.
Mm-hmm.
And let that go. And while we're doing this, let's talk about the restaurant itself. Let's tell everybody where it is, what you guys got going on.
Take it away, chef.
You can. I am flipping pumpkin skins.
Cobb, it's been around for 24 years in the jewelry district.
Yep.
It's what people call as a hidden gem,
mm-hmm.
which it is certainly hidden
sure.
and a gem, so that's appropriate. And
Sylvia is the owner. Beautiful lady, always gracious, comes up to everybody, makes sure that you have great experience. Make sure all the food is perfect, that you loved every moment of it.
Right. And this time of year for you guys as chefs, is it great to be cooking this time of year? You like the fall
this
flavors?
This is
Absolutely.
My favorite kind of cooking.
Yeah.
Lamb shanks, a little heartier, more.
Right.
This
stick to your ribs kind of food.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
This actually started as a special, and people loved it so much, we just added it on the menu permanently.
Oh, okay.
His fall is just exciting. Makes
yes,
you want to cook.
Yes, it is. Yeah. People love being in downtown Providence this time of year. All right, so this is going along?
Yeah, we're ready now. It's saucy, you know?
Okay.
So we're going to turn the heat off of it.
Okay.
And throw the raviolis.
And here come the raviolis. And now, did you make these raviolis? Do you make the raviolis like this at the restaurant yourself, or...?
These ones, well, just because they're new on the menu, we
right.
get actually from Venda Ravioli.
Oh, right.
So you can buy them
yeah.
pre-made and frozen. And they're really, I mean, they
they're
have...
perfect.
Yeah, they're really good, so. Here we go.
Turn
that back on.
Turn that on.
And that's it. So you just want to get it all coated and good. And
okay.
reduce that sauce a little bit more. Don't want it too watery. And the last thing we're going to do before plating is just throw that spinach in.
But
you want to do it at the end so it's not overcooked.
So it doesn't, and it doesn't wilt up too much, right?
Mm-hmm.
The spinach will wilt up too much. All right, yeah. So how long will this stay on for?
Oh, I think we only have about 30 more seconds here,
okay.
maybe.
All right, so we'll let this simmer along. Smells really good. So we'll put this together. We'll let this simmer along, and then we're going to show you what the finished product looks like, too, in just a little bit, too. So,
great.
If you want this recipe, if you want more info about Cobb itself, mm-hmm. it smells really good, easy to make for dinner tonight. You can do it. All you have to do is head to our website, WPRI.com.